Okay, we're a quarter of the way down the trail, and we have a little guide here that shows you the kind of trees that grow around here. There are the exotic kind of trees, so I don't think they're from around here, and then there are native trees as well. This is a good guide, so you know exactly what's growing around here. We also noticed that there are mosquitoes. This is like man versus wild. So, but if you're, you know, if you're gonna come here, you might want Human Nature's Citronella Bug Spray. Apply directly to the skin so that the mosquitoes won't bug you. Alright, so that's what I'm gonna do. My wife's already done her part. Just keep rolling, yeah? Okay, don't take me because I'll be... You can take it now. Been bitten a couple of times already.
Ow. I think I need more for my legs.
Yeah, the mosquitoes are quite formidable in these parts of Cebu. I've been bitten 3 times and I can see blood in my finger as well. So let's just say the mosquitoes have here have big teeth. We also heard the elusive Vidioque bird earlier down the trail. Only in the Philippines such an animal exists, only in the Philippines. So hopefully we'll catch a glimpse of the Vidioque bird. Now we have our snacks here and our binoculars. We'll be using it later. Is there an opening down there?
Yes.
That we can see around the valley?
Mm-hmm.
So later on we'll be able to see a wider shot of the valley, and that should be a really, that should be a really nice view. Ow! My legs are getting bit. I think I need more of that organic stuff. Keep it organic, people. Don't want any toxins in your body anyway. I'm actually starting to sweat. It's supposed to be it's actually cool up here. But the walk, the hike down can be quite tiring. And yeah, I'm a city boy, so it's only been like, what, 5 or 10 minutes and I'm already sweating. Where is she going? Honey? Okay. So I haven't seen any other signs here that tell us what kind of trees are growing here. And I wasn't really paying attention to that chart earlier. But what I can tell you is there are some trees here that are with places in Cebu that have been named after the trees, like the Mabolo, the Katmon, and the Banilad. Those are all trees. I did not know that until today. So I guess that makes me really dumb. Alright. Continuing down the trail. I am assuming and I hope that we're halfway there, or at least almost there. This is gonna be a pretty boring video. But for anyone who is into nature, this is actually one of the best action flicks ever. You saw a spider web? I hate spiders. Well, there's a hut there, hidden in the foliage. And the trail continues. Not too difficult because of the steps. I wonder what it was like a long time ago without the steps. That must have been a lot more fun. But you know, this is probably one of those preserved places right now, so they have budget to make it easier for tourists and visitors to get around which is all right, I guess. It kind of reminds me of that sequoia forest in the States a little. Okay, here we have another chart, and it tells us about the birds in Kanirag. Wow, this is pretty cool. Mosquitoes are not birds. All right, and there's the kingfisher, the zebra dove, the grass owl, the sunbird, barred rail, starling, and orioles. Very cool. So these are some of the birds that can be found in Kanirag. So hopefully we'll be able to spy on some like that. Get over there. Yeah. And it's a little something about why birds are important, you know, like how they help spread the seed of the trees and the pollination and all that. Actually, I'm more impressed with bees. Without the bees, we'd be dead. For reals. A lot of mosquitoes. They don't get much blood around here, I guess. There's absolutely nobody around here. It's actually a great place to date, I guess. It's just getting here that seems to be the problem. As you can see here, you have this white stuff on the tree. I believe that's lichen. Not as in the werewolf lichen, but the fungus lichen. And the more lichen there is, I believe that means there's less pollution. I'm not sure. If you don't see lichen on your trees, it's polluted. The area is polluted. But there's lichen on these trees, so there should be, the air is really good here. That's a good indication that the air is really great. No, not werewolves. Alright, continuing down the trail. And there's another outpost over there. Gabi? The plant? There's rhubarb here? Kara, permaculturist. Okay, oh, we see some flowers now. See those, if you can see those pink flowers. Yes, we're getting a better view of things around here. So, this is the ilang ilang tree. I believe this is native. And here we have more flora. So it's really actually a nature and bird park, nature and bird sanctuary, I'd say. There's not much you wouldn't say. I don't think you'd expect to see monkeys around here. And here's a little graph about the watershed, what a watershed is, what it does. There's the water cycle diagram. So this is a great place for students. Field trips would be awesome here. Kids would love this place, really. Running around with, you know, I don't think they'd pay attention to the scientific stuff, but this is a really great place to run around. Kids would love it here. So if any of you guys have any of your teachers and you want, you know, field trips, Kanirag would be the best place to hold those field trips. And I'm gonna go up and check out what my wife is looking at, and I'll be shutting off this clip for now because it's almost at the 10-minute mark. So see you guys later.